We are following breaking news at 5. Former Illinois Speaker of the House Michael Madigan has been indicted on racketeering and bribery charges. According to the 106-page indictment, he is charged with 22 counts. Previously implicated in the ComEd bribery scheme, but he had only been identified as Public Official A. A half a dozen of his allies have been charged with crimes, including Madigan's longtime chief of staff and multiple former ComEd executives. Here's the announcement just a short time ago.
The indictment alleges that Madigan, McLean, and other members of the enterprise unlawfully solicited benefits from businesses and other private parties. As alleged in the indictment, Madigan and McLean unlawfully requested that various companies and interests with interest in state legislation, including utility company Commonwealth Edison, pay Madigan's associates as a reward for their loyalty to Madigan, at times in return for performing little to no legitimate work for those businesses.
Let's go right to WGN's Mike Lowe, who was at that conference. Mike, what can you tell us?
Well, I just stepped out of the media briefing in which U.S. Attorney John Lausch announced these federal racketeering, conspiracy, and bribery charges against Michael J. Madigan, known as the Velvet Hammer for his quietly domineering rule over Springfield and really Illinois politics for the last 50 years. The indictment was returned by a grand jury after a two-year investigation into this alleged corruption. The indictment says that he should forfeit more than $2 million in ill-gotten gains. It says the 79-year-old former House Speaker, of course, resigned his seat last year, so he is no longer the Speaker. But this 100-page indictment contains 22 counts alleging that Madigan was the boss of a criminal organization that federal prosecutors call the, quote, Madigan Enterprise. And they say its purpose was, quote, to preserve and enhance Madigan's political power and financial well-being. They say this enterprise lasted more than a decade. Of course, Madigan was in power for, as Speaker of the House, more than 40 years. But this investigation, according to John Lausch, only the four corners, he says, of this indictment only looked at the last 10 years or so. Also charged today, announced by the U.S. attorney, was Madigan's longtime right-hand man, Michael McLean. The allegations there are that he kind of carried out the bribery scheme that involved Commonwealth Edison, and that he also carried out a number of other illegal acts on behalf of Michael Madigan. Now, it is important to note that Madigan has repeatedly denied any wrongdoing in all of this. Again, we just left the news conference where this was all announced. So I've just come down to the Dirksen Federal Building, but we are certain to hear more as we go through this 22-count indictment, more than 100 pages of information here regarding one of the biggest fish to be netted in this corruption, ongoing corruption investigation into Illinois politics. Back to you.
Mike, they say the investigation continues.
Indeed, they say this is an ongoing investigation, and U.S. Attorney John Lausch said that if there are more things discovered, sometimes they'll bring an indictment and then find out that there are more things, they'll get more information, other people will talk. So they said there could be more charges at some time in the future, but right now this is a 22-count indictment. He said the most serious charge carries with it a 20-year prison sentence.
All right. Thank you, Mike. WGN Investigate has been reporting on Madigan and his questionable conduct for more than a decade.
Yeah, our stories have included details of Madigan's lucrative law practice and how he wields power in our state. And investigative reporter Ben Bradley is joining us now with more on how both of these factors played a role in the indictment today. Mm-hmm. This black cloud has been hanging over him for some time. Many thought, you're never going to get Mike Madigan, and today that all changed.
No, it's the confluence of this private law practice that he's run. They did property tax appeals and his public office. How he wielded power in both of those cases is at the heart of this indictment. Specifically, it essentially says Mike Madigan ran a criminal enterprise. This isn't that different from how the feds would have charged Al Capone or a mob leader back in the day, saying, you know what? People were working on his behalf to keep him in power, to make him money, and to get his favor on legislation. That's at the heart of what this case is about for Mike Madigan. And in it, they have Mike Madigan talking about his private law practice, wanting a big Chicago developer who had a piece of property in Chinatown to use his private law practice. They also talk about how his cronies were on the payroll at ComEd, how they'd get lobbying contracts. What they don't appear to have a lot of is Mike Madigan on tape admitting wrongdoing, saying something like, give me the money. But let's walk through real quickly, guys, the timeline of this event. Back in May of 2019, that was the first time we really learned the feds were looking hard at Madigan, and there were a bunch of raids on people connected to him. And then in July of 2020, a year and a half ago, that huge bombshell, ComEd admitted wrongdoing, was fined $200 million, and hugely important, ComEd said it put people on the payroll and hired law firms and lobbyists to curry favor with Mike Madigan. Then in November of 2020, Mike McLean, who's a former lawmaker, very close, one of few people very close to Mike Madigan, indicted. And then, of course, February 21, 2021, Madigan resigned. We're almost a year, at more than a year after his resignation, and we have charges now.
You gotta wonder, Madigan crossed T's, dotted I's, watched his back big time, had his cronies watching his back. Where was the trip up?
That's a great question. We don't know it yet because...
Glaus says it's within the confines of the indictment, but that's 106 pages
but
to get
But there's a big difference between having somebody who will testify that, you know, say the CEO of ComEd saying, yeah, we hired this person or we gave that person a no-show job because we wanted Madigan's favor, and having somebody who will actually say, well, no, Mike Madigan told me to do that. And that makes a big difference from a legal standpoint and a jury standpoint if this case does, in fact, go before a jury. But there was a great question asked of Laus, I thought, in that news conference, and that question was, can any politician have a private law practice, as many do, and do it legally? Because that is how we've seen Ed Burke get into trouble, the alderman.
In trouble
we've
right
seen
now.
Other folks get into trouble. It's that confluence of events that so often has people doing favors, hiring friends, giving money.
Where is that edge?
Yeah.
Where is that gray scale?
Absolutely.
Ben, we appreciate your coverage on this for us. We'll be talking to you throughout the evening. Well, Governor Pritzker.